My name is Stefan Spindler. I'm holding the Chair of Logistics Management, which is sponsored by the Kühne Foundation. We are here with WHU Inside Business, and I would like to welcome Dr. Rod Franklin from the KU. Rod, thanks very much for coming. And what I would like to do is to discuss a number of topics with you in terms of what is the relevance of logistics, how can logistics become more flexible, and finally, what is the relationship between logistics and sustainability? Now, in terms of relevance, how relevant is logistics today in the corporate world? What would you say?
Well, unfortunately, in the corporate world, it's probably ignored more than it is recognized. But in the real world, everything is logistics. You can't eat if there's not logistics, because who takes the food to the market where you buy the food? You don't get your car, because the car is brought to your city via logistics. You don't get all of your household goods unless there's a logistics process behind it. And this goes on and on and on. So in reality, logistics is probably one of the most important industries in the world, which is, again, unfortunate that management at most companies look at logistics as an afterthought.
What would you advise? How should companies, or should they, companies change in terms of recognizing this crucial role of logistics?
Well, I think that we are seeing some change. I mean, the fact that here at the WHU you have the focus of logistics in one of your areas, the fact that the Kühne Logistics University was set up. We're starting to see education more in the area of supply chain and logistics. And I think that that will bleed into the management ranks as these students who graduate begin to move up. That's one area. I think other areas that are beginning to impose logistics on people are companies that are coming like Amazon, where they are driving the, I would call, cachet of logistics up in the knowledge base. So again, I think we're going to see that logistics becomes recognized more and more. It's more a matter of time now, as opposed to 20 years ago, when I sort of got in, started around, where logistics wasn't really respected all that much.
Right. It seems as though logistics is exposed to quite a bit of competitive pressure, logistics companies. How do companies cope with this pressure? What's their strategies to deal with that?
Well, I think certainly efficiency is a focus of all logistics companies. I always find it surprising when people say logistics is inefficient. Well, it has inefficiencies built into it, but people are trying to extract them out because of the competitive nature. But we're also seeing technology now start to impose new ideas in the industry and force change, which actually improves competitiveness and efficiency as well.
Right. What are some of the technologies that you would think are of primary importance right now?
Well, I think the Internet of Things, being able to instrument everything, is very important, because it improves tracking and tracing, which helps in inventory management, which also helps in delivery performance and these types of things. We see telematics in vehicles helping in how drivers use their vehicles in routings and things like that. And we're also seeing investments by governments in smart infrastructures, so that highways are becoming smarter and things are moving in a direction where we may start to see that autonomous Google car come into being as autonomous trucks. So again, I think we're seeing some very interesting things going on
right
there.
So does that mean that the future supply chain manager or logistics manager needs to be tech-savvy, or at least have some affinity towards technology?
I think that they need to be tech-aware, and how to employ it from a business perspective. I mean, technology by itself is interesting. It's a nice hobby. But it's not something that generates business unless you're selling the technology. So for a logistics professional, they need to be aware of how technology can enable what they're trying to do, but they don't necessarily need to be what I would call a technologist or propeller head, as sometimes we call people who are a little too technical.
Okay. Do you see a potential for technology such as in particular digital technologies to enable a greater extent of flexibility within the supply chain?
Certainly. I think that digitalization, new systems, smart objects, if you will, with the Internet of Things, all are converging on a concept of higher flexibility, higher ability to manage and scale, and to operate logistics networks in a unit of one characteristic.
Okay. Let's get to one last topic related to sustainability. How sustainable is right now the logistics industry?
Well, I think that the industry, we need to look at how we define sustainability. If we're defining sustainability as it generally is assumed in the public, which is more aligned with efficiency, I think we have a very good story to tell in the logistics industry because, again, the competitive pressures and the narrow margins are forcing the industry to be extremely efficient. Is that sustainable? Well, here we have to look at a bigger picture issue. As companies have spread across the globe, they've lengthened their supply chains, they've gone to markets that have been less developed and had less regulatory requirements, and all of that packaged together has resulted probably in less sustainability, even though the industry itself, logistics industry, has become more efficient. What we're going to have to see if we're going to make this all sustainable in the future is how we can condense and bring back lots and lots of this long-distance supply chain operations to more short-term, rapid delivery, concise, as I said, units of one type supply chains, where we then have the ability to really reduce the carbon footprint and help our environment.
Okay. Last year we had what sometimes some people call breakthrough in the COP21 negotiations in terms of defining a roadmap for CO2 reduction. Mm-hmm. Do you share this enthusiasm about this accord? And if so, or if not, what is going to be the impact of that particular agreement on future supply chains?
Well, I think it was the best of a bad deal. I think that we aren't going to see a lot of change. Industry is still going to pursue what the customer is driving them to pursue. Countries are still very protective, as you've seen very recently with the willingness of the European Union to impose stricter emission standards on automobiles here in the Union, particularly the diesel vehicles. So I think that there are always going to be trade-offs made. I think that the big thing that the COP21 Accord does is it brings again to the agenda of the public as well as the public administrators that we need to do something because my personal belief is it's a bit too late to try and achieve what was originally desired from a CO2 reduction level. And now we have to take a look at what can be done with reduction in that area, as well as how do we mitigate the problems that are already in the process of occurring.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you.